God of hope give you the fullness of peace, and may the Lord of life be always with you. In the waters of baptism, Elaine died with Christ and rose with him in new life. May she now share with him eternal glory.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Good morning, everyone. I welcome you all here to the church this morning as we gather to say farewell to Elaine. She's reached the end of her time in this world and now goes on to her time of eternal life. The readings that we listen to today will speak of the qualities of love, both from the prophet Micah and in the Beatitudes of the Gospel. And love is what leads us to virtue. And the scriptures tell us that the virtuous are in the hands of God. They are at peace. And so we gather to pray for Elaine's peace today. We commend her to her eternal home where she'll share in the Lord's glory. And we pray also for peace for her family and friends. Peace to Ken, for Ella, to Elaine's mam Rose and her aunt Marie, her brother Ger, Ken's parents Phyllis and Brendan, her sisters-in-law Lilian, Heather, Audrey, Vivienne and Elaine, her brother-in-law Graham, and all her nieces and nephews and extended family, friends, neighbours. Many people have gathered here today to pray for Elaine, and I'm sure many more would have liked to have been here, and many of them are gathering with us through the live stream. We're all united together in prayer. As we begin our Mass, we're going to bring up to the sanctuary here some symbols of the things that gave great joy and enjoyment to Elaine in life. They speak of her character and they bring us happy memories. And Ger and Ken and Ella are going to tell us a little bit about Elaine and also about the symbols that we're bringing forward. So we'd like to come forward now.
Thanks everyone for coming. You probably know back in April we lost our brother David. He was 45. Elaine was 51. She lived near a golf club, so in golfing terms, she's the clubhouse leader. And there's only one player left on the course. There was 18 months between us, but because she was a girl and I was a boy, the fighting was epic. plenty of it happened. After school, she went to Plunkett College before joining the workplace. She worked in the eye clinic in Beaumont Hospital. She eventually found her work family in Quintiles, before her actual work family with Ken. They moved to Laytown, where Ken proposed in a way that puts the rest of us to shame. I remember giving her away at her wedding. She was so happy and so stunning. They honeymooned in South Africa, kicking off a lot of spectacular travelling. While she was pregnant with Ella, she got her first diagnosis with cancer. She fought and won that battle. Ella was born. We got together a few years ago to celebrate 10 years cancer-free. I think it's the only occasion where the whole family were together. She packed a lot into those 10 years, traveling to Australia, New Zealand, US, many other places. If you were in the house yesterday, you'll see the photos from everywhere. She was such a generous person. She'd never forget a birthday, an anniversary, or even a I saw this and thought of you day. Even during COVID, the Amazon man was still coming to the door. She loved her family. She loved traveling. She loved her garden. She loved her dog. She She loved the beach and, of course, elephants. Most of all, she loved Ken and Ella, and she was so proud of Ella. I think last night, the one thing that everyone had in common was that they said that she was such a lady. And the slideshow that we had showed a beautiful, smiley lady. But then, less than a year ago, the cancer came back, and she kept smiling all the way through it. I hope you're smiling now, Elaine. God bless. Rest in peace.
A wooden mallet, chloroform, Elaine's brain being unable to distinguish certain shapes. There were many theories as to why Elaine chose me. The real answer is her love of physical humour. As I crashed around her life, she would go into fits of giggles and call me a clown. I would retort, at least I'm not a clown marrier. And she would say, who would have you but me? And I would love these moments with her because she would try so hard not to laugh. And I would pretend to be upset in that moment, staring at her until she could hold it in no longer and a stream of tears and laughter would ensue. One thing my family knows about me, I'm a spoofer. And I'm about to let you all in on the biggest spoof that none of you pretty much know. I even spoofed last night to lovely Heather about this. And I'm going to tell you the truth about how myself and Elaine really met. I told Heather it was in a bar in town and Elaine came up to me. And obviously she couldn't argue. And I thank you, Heather, for believing me that she came up to me. That was just so good for my spirit at that moment. Thank you so much. But the truth is, we met in an unusual way, or at least then. I met Elaine online. I know, kind of strange for back then. It wasn't Clounder, in case you're wondering, or some strange thing like that. But there was no pictures. In fact, I've been talking previously to someone else, and when we got to the picture exchange, there's a current picture going around the family that they say I was trying to look like James Bond in the picture. And I sent it to that lady, and I never heard from her again. And that's absolutely the truth. But back to Elaine, or should I say Lonnie, which was our online name when I met her. And I was Mr. Darcy. I think it kind of sets the scene. Maybe you have me pictured coming out of a lake half-dressed, or at least this was what I was attempting to go for in my marketing stance of myself. Oh, God. We'd started messaging back and forth, and I joke with you not. Obviously, we absolutely clicked, but imagine everyone. If the first time, the first moment you met who was to become your wife, the first thing you heard was her voice, because I talked to her over the phone. And Elaine had this gorgeous voice that I was convinced we could make money off. It was just beautiful voice. And then we decided to meet in Malahide, and a gentle hand took over. And I'll explain why in a moment. But I met her, and I felt confident. And Elaine, she is so beautiful. She was so beautiful. But we clicked. It was supposed to be for a short drink, but we ended up going for a long walk on the beach. I remember touching her hand for the first time and holding it. I remember then, because we were just having so much fun going for dinner together, the non-stop talk, and then in the car, the first kiss. The first kiss. Now, why a gentle hand took over? Because the second time, we decided I would pick her up from her house, but it was too soon to meet Rose, to meet Mary. So she was to come out of the house, and when she did, she walked in front of the car. She literally took my breath away. I was like, what did I just see on the first date? No. Oh my God, she's out of my league. And I was so nervous and so pleased it was a cinema date. Because if I had felt the way I had felt at that moment, I might have ruined everything. I don't know if you remember a program called Melrose Place. There was this blonde-haired actress, absolutely beautiful, absolutely pretty. And Elaine and her were just a spit of each other. And I was like, wow. Glenn, it's not where you started, it's where you end up. This girl is amazing. She talked so beautifully to me. Oh, God. I'll continue on if I may. At each date, as it occurred, this beautiful personality with the same loves and values emerged. She would happily watch Chelsea matches with me as if a full supporter until she had the ring on her finger. Then she refused to watch another Chelsea match with me. What is that about? And then she went to a work do at Hudson Bay Hotel. Those who know Elaine here know she loved wine. Now, don't get me wrong, not in a type of way, but she loved her wine. It was gorgeous. But what's one of the things that maybe few of you know about her, and then forgive her, is she loved cigars. I don't, excuse me. And at 11:45, after a few wines and two cigars, she rang me. Or Darth Vader rang me, I'm not sure. And she told me for the first time she loved me. As I said, it could have been Darth Vader, but I'm a big Star Wars fan, so I'll take either. So we were madly in love. Friends would give out to me especially, because I couldn't leave her alone. I had to keep holding her hand. But during this period of mad, mad love, two dark people started to conspire. Their names, Brendan and Phyllis Glynn. They somehow had grown to believe that a 29-year-old man living at home wasn't the way to live a life, even though I promised them that I would go out feet first. And one morning, without me knowing it, they got in their car and went for a drive with an evil purpose. They came to Bettystown and chose my house. And they sold it. They sold it that Elaine could move in with me in the way we would do it, because it would be a slow start. It would be too fast. Elaine would move in on just weekends. And we'd slowly, gradually move in together. Elaine moved in that first weekend and never moved out again. And it was such an adventure. From everyday small things to somehow managing to get a business trip to Australia, which the company paid for Elaine as well. And then the greatest adventure of all, as she waved the pregnancy test at me. Her beautiful Ella was on the way. Her pride and joy and her greatest, greatest achievement. She's so proud of you, Ella. She'll always be so proud of you. You should know this, as every picture on Facebook started to be just of her, and I would be slowly chopped out. You'd have to go back years and years where I had this big bushy head of hair, and you'd go, surely he's not married to him, he's far too young for her. If you managed to find a picture from way, way back then, they were all pictures of Ella. But then, 4 months into that pregnancy, she got cancer. And a version of Elaine that I had not met appeared. An absolute warrior. An absolute warrior. We had no idea how bad it was, because Ella was within her They couldn't assess how bad the cancer was. And she just was so strong, so happy, and she was going to beat it. And that's exactly what she did. She took it on and she beat it with a husband that was sobbing in the shower. But she was always strong for herself and her family. So she beat it. And then for the next 13 years, we had this cloud that it could come back. But she was my warrior at that stage. And it was all about adventures. It was New Zealand, it was Australia, it was South Africa again. We were constantly traveling, trying to make the most of the life that we had. I even had a catchphrase for our life. You want to hear it? It was, summer is not a season, it's a destination. That's what I would talk about our lives, because that's what it was like. We wanted to have so much fun in the everyday. And raising Ella was such a privilege and so much fun. And then last week, my clumsiness struck again. And she started laughing. And as it started to conclude, I said, well, who'd have me? And for the first time, she went off script. Absolutely loads. So many would have you. Elaine, you are my soulmate, my best friend, the love of my life. As our planet races through our solar system, you are my co-pilot. I love you forever, bud. Sleep well.
Hi everybody, I'm Elaine, Elaine's sister-in-law. Ella's asked me to read out this beautiful words she wants you to tell you about her mum. She's asked me to read it out this morning, and she's going to bring up some of the items that she collected that were all about her mum, Elaine, while I read this out, okay, on her behalf. Things I want you to know about mum. What a great person she was. Sometimes when she went to Dublin, she would buy a coffee and a meal for a homeless person on the street. Elephants. In every room in our house, there are elephants. Do you want to raise that up and show everybody? I remember when my mum, dad and I got to meet elephants up close in South Africa. I had never seen her so happy about anything other than our family. What a great mum she was. We were late for a boat trip to see the waterfalls in New Zealand, and I felt sick being in the car because Dad was speeding. Mum was helping me, but as soon as we got out of the car, I got sick. And when we got on the boat, Mum spent the entire time with me, looking after me and making sure I felt better. Whenever I was sick, she didn't care if she caught what I had. She would sit with me and we'd cuddle on the sofa and watch Mamma Mia and The Sound of Music. They are some of my best memories with her. She was really good at taking care of herself and her health. She walked every day with me, Bowie, our dog, and we have a picture of Bowie here with us because Bowie can't be with us in the church, and she walked by herself as well. She watched what she ate and how healthy she was and always tried to eat well. She went to the gym a lot to improve her health. And this hand weight is a symbol of her love for working out and looking after herself. Me and Dad were talking about how we are going to be healthier and look after ourselves very well in honor of her. She loved her home and her house and making sure it was spotless and tidy at all times. The only time me and Mum really argued was over my floor drobe. She was so proud of her home and garden. She absolutely loved her garden and tinkering around, adding plants and garden decorations. The garden decoration here with us was bought by my mum very recently. She never got to put it in our garden. So after today, I'm going to find a spot for it and we'll start taking care of the garden in her name. She loved fashion and taking care of her appearance. Her wardrobe is packed with clothes, but very organised. She was still buying clothes until very recently. She ordered a cardigan last week that she had wanted for ages. Reading, something Mum and I adored. There wasn't a day that I didn't see her read. We used to snuggle up on the couch or in her bed and read together. She could read for hours. She had 202 pages of books on her Kindle, which has just been left there, which has 6 books per page, which means on that Kindle alone, she has now read over 1,212 books. I was going to buy her a new Kindle for her next birthday. Thanks for being such a great mum. Now I'm going to read a poem, and it's called Memories of You, Mum. It's been the hardest thing to lose you. You meant so much to me. But you are in my heart, Mum, and that's where you'll always be. I know that heaven called you, but I wish you could have stayed. At least the memories I have of you, they will never fade. I did not want to lose you, but you did not go alone, because a part of me went with you when heaven called you home. So just remember one thing, we are not apart. You're with me in my memories and in my broken heart. And Ella wrote that yesterday for her mum.
Many thanks to Ella and Ger and Mr. Darcy or Ken for sharing those beautiful, very personal memories that really describe Elaine in such a beautiful way, the beautiful person that she was. And now we place ourselves in the presence of the Lord who gathers us around Elaine today. We ask him to take her to the glories of heaven and to unite her with all those who have gone before us, especially her dad, Hughie, and her brother, David, and all her relations. May the Lord cast his love and light on them all. Lord Jesus, you raised the dead to life in the Spirit. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you bring pardon and peace to the sinner. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you bring light to those in darkness. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. Listen kindly to our prayers, O Lord, as our faith in your Son raised from the dead is deepened. May our hope of resurrection for your departed servant Elaine also find new strength. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God for ever and ever. So now we're going to listen to our readings from the scriptures, and Audrey is going to read the first reading, then Ryan is going to play a psalm, and then after the psalm, Lilian will read the second reading.
First reading, a reading from the prophet Micah. What is it the Lord asks of you? Only this, that you act justly, that you love tenderly, and that you humbly walk with your God. This is the word of the Lord.
But you shall not die of thirst. You shall wander far in safety, though you do not know the way. You shall speak your words in foreign lands, and all.
A letter from St. Paul to Timothy. I have fought the good fight to the end. I have run the race to the finish. I have kept the faith. All there is now is the crown of righteousness reserved for me, which the Lord will give not only to me, but to all those who long for his appearing. The word of the Lord.
Please stand now for the Gospel acclamation. Alleluia, alleluia. Come, you whom my Father has blessed, says the Lord. Take for your heritage the kingdom prepared for you since the foundation of the world. Alleluia. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain, and after he sat down, his disciples came to him. Then he began to speak and taught them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, they will be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they will receive mercy. Blessed are the poor in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are those persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven." The Gospel of the Lord. Please be seated now for a few moments. In the words of that Gospel that Elaine's family chose for today, Jesus sets out the core of his teaching. Where Moses announced the Ten Commandments, Jesus teaches the Beatitudes. Moses gave laws and rules. Jesus gives values and standards. He proclaims ideals to treasure, ideals to nurture, ideals to live. Jesus calls us to a set of ideals that could transform the world. The Beatitudes contain teachings that we can be proud of. We know that Gandhi knew them and he recited them often. St. Paul says somewhere that those who take the message of Christ to heart are like earthenware jars that hold a great treasure. And today's Gospel holds up that treasure for us to see. Jesus asks us to be poor in spirit, gentle, people who respect grief. He asks us to hunger and thirst for what is right, to be merciful, to be pure in heart, to be peacemakers, to take the side of right even in the face of persecution, to be a fighter when needed. And these are the things that anyone can do. Any parent can do, any child can do, any teenager can do. To be gentle, merciful, and a peacemaker. The words that we associate with Elaine today, words used by her family and by her good friends, are words that describe her as gentle, a lady, unselfish, positive, caring. And these are words that come readily to people's lips without hesitation because they are words that they have seen in action in Elaine's life, embodying the qualities, the very goodness that is set before us in the Beatitudes, as we heard so beautifully described for us by Ger and Ken and Ella at the beginning. A life growing up in Drumcondra, being schooled in St. Vincent de Paul Primary School. And Elaine was considered from an early age a gentle person with a heart of gold, despite the family rows that might happen between brother and sister. The joy of her family, she was full of compassion, warmth, and humour. She looked out for the neighbour and enjoyed the company of her friends. It was the type of child that she was, and later the loving and caring adult that she became, that endeared so many people to her. Reading the condolences on the internet, her friends remembered the generosity of the time that she gave, her thoughtfulness, the special qualities that she had. One recalled a particular summer of pop music, making tapes while growing up. Ella is following in her footsteps today, choosing and compiling pieces that she enjoyed for our ceremony. Elaine's work colleagues remember her contribution too. Quintiles was maybe her main work home, although she worked in many places. But there was a lovely tribute from the colleagues she worked with in the Beacon Project, describing what a pleasure it was to work with Elaine over the years. Elaine's lovely manner and professionalism, it said, created a very positive and enjoyable working environment. People who knew Elaine wouldn't be surprised at that. Elaine always had time to stop for a chat. It might be a neighbour passing by, admiring the garden. I'm sure she might share some of the secrets that she had as to how the garden was looking so well all the time. Or maybe it was bumping into someone when she was bringing Bowie for a much appreciated walk. She never didn't have the time to stop for a few minutes, sharing joy, a laugh, and catching up. People say that Elaine had the gift of lifting their spirits and pointing to a brighter side of whatever might be troubling them. There was a depth to her. There was a rock, an inner strength. And Ken and Ella spoke about that, and all her family knew that. Elaine loved Ken and Ella and was so strong for them. And you were strong for her too. Being there for others in good times and in bad, isn't that what true love is all about? Elaine was especially there for Ken and Ella, but it wasn't just them. She was there for her mother Rose and Marie and her brother Jer and all the extended family, and Lilian when David passed away so suddenly earlier this year. Elaine knew what it is to go through difficult times. Those words spoken by Jesus in the Beatitudes were very real for her at times, as they are real for all of us who gather around her today. Blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted. Blessed are they who come through the trials and stand on the right side. Theirs is the kingdom of heaven. When Jesus speaks of the reward that awaits us in heaven, there's a very real link with the lives that we live here, the characters that we are, the relationships that we share, the good that we have done. The love that we have together transcends even death itself. The kind of love that was in Elaine's heart is a love that endures. It's the kind of love that we see in those who live the Beatitudes. And it's the kind of love that Jesus tells us is rewarded when, after having fought the good fight, we make our way to heaven and to the prize that awaits us. This is exactly what Elaine did. Elaine acted justly, loved tenderly, walked humbly with God. She ran the race to the finish and kept the faith. And the crown of righteousness awaits her. And for that we are so thankful. In our prayers today, we commend Elaine to the Lord. We thank God for revealing to us something of the kingdom of God through her. And if we, like Elaine, follow the way of life that Jesus marks out in the Beatitudes, then we will find the life of God's kingdom in heaven, yes, and also even here on earth. Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord. Let perpetual light shine upon her. May she rest in peace. May her soul and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. invite you to stand now as we have the prayer of the faithful, and those who are reading the prayers can come forward now. And let us pray with confidence and trust in the power of God, who raised Jesus from the dead and whose promise is that one day we shall be like him.
In gratitude for Elaine, for precious memories, and for the good she did for others, Lord, hear us.
For all those who will miss Elaine, that the Lord may give them his comfort and be their companion during this time of sorrow, Lord, hear us.
For ourselves, we are gathered at the table of the Lord, that we may be gathered together again in God's kingdom. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For all God's people, that we may set our hearts on the things of heaven and be faithful in our service of God and neighbour. Lord, hear us. For Elaine's carers, the doctors, nurses and others, in Beaumont and elsewhere, may you reward them for their care and dedication. Lord, hear us.
Lord God, whose days are without end and whose mercies are beyond counting, keep us mindful that the hour of death is unknown. Let your Spirit guide our days on earth in the ways of justice and peace, that we may serve you in union with the whole Church, sure in faith, strong in hope, and perfect in love. And when our earthly journey is ended, lead us rejoicing into your kingdom, where you live forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated now as our gifts of bread and wine are brought to the altar, and Scott and Tara are going to bring forward the gifts.
Children of our own, yeah, still kiss the whistle.
And pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Look favourably on our offerings, O Lord, so that your departed servant Elaine may be taken up into glory with your Son, in whose great mystery of love we are all united. We ask this through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. His death we celebrate in love. His resurrection we confess with living faith. And his coming in glory we await with unwavering hope. And so with all the angels and saints we praise you, as without end we acclaim. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Tom our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember your servant Elaine, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she, who is united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours, for ever and ever. Amen. And please stand now. Jesus taught us to call God our Father, and so we now have the courage to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign for ever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. We offer each other a sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Who can live without it? I ask thee, Lord.
is going to lead our communion reflection.
I feel your sorrow and appreciate your prayers. When you are lonely, know that I am nearby for you. While I'm no longer on earth, I'm in a new place, a place too beautiful to describe. It's a place of peace, comfort, and love. A place so warm and wonderful it defies imagination. While you are so sad now, you will grow in strength. You can turn to me in prayer. Please do. You can continue to love me. I will watch over you, though for now you will not be able to see or touch me. You are still on earth and meant to be here for now. You will grieve. It isn't easy. Death is always sad. But believe that someday we'll be reunited to be all that we can be with God and loved ones. Amen.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that your servant Elaine, for whom we have celebrated this Paschal sacrament, may pass over to a dwelling place of light and peace. We ask this through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. Trusting in God, we have prayed together for Elaine, and now we come to the last farewell. There's sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see Elaine again and enjoy her friendship. Although this congregation may disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdom. And therefore, let us console one another in the faith of Jesus Christ. Please pray now for Elaine as we reverence her remains with holy water, reminding us of the day of our baptism, and also with incense symbolising our prayers for Elaine rising to the thrones of heaven.
We said we walk together, baby, come with me. That comes to wild eye, should we lose her? As we're walking, should I fall behind? Wait for me. We slowly travel down side by side. We help each other to stay in the stride. But each lover steps far, so differently, but I'll be fair. Should I fall behind?
Response to our song of farewell is, receive her soul and present her to God the Most High. Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High. Saints of God, come to her aid. Hasten to meet her, angels of the Lord. May Christ who called you take you to himself. May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham. Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her. Into your hands, Father of Mercies, we commend our sister Elaine, in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Elaine in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant, and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ, and we are with you and with our sister Elaine forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord. And please stand now as in peace we take our sister to her place of rest.
back on 6th Street, hearing you whisper through the phone. Wait for me to come home.
Get all excited by the